This video is made possible thanks to the lovely sponsor down below, SALH. Thank you so much for your support. Hello everybody, it's Dreaming Mind here. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. With a new event, we will be getting a new magical ghoul. We already know Kanagi Izumi, so we're gonna see what she is made of. And go over her stats, connect Magia, Double, and Team and Memonia recommendations. Kanagi is a permanent light magical girl, and as a 5-star, she has a max HP of 21,754, a max attack of 9,695, and a max defense of 7,386. Compared to the other 5-star light magical girls, her HP is quite low, and still low when compared to all the other 5-stars. However, she will have the second highest attack out of all 5-star light magical girls, so of course her attack is still high when compared to the other 5-stars. Finally, her defense is once again low when compared to the other 5-star light magical girls, and slightly below average when compared to the other 5-stars in general. She is an attack type, and her growth and leveling is focused on her attack and defense. When taking a look at her discs, we can see that she has one charge disc, one horizontal and one vertical blast disc, and two XL discs. Her MP gain is okay. From a XL charge XL combination, you can earn around 38 MP. Let's move on to her connect Magia and Double. Kanagi's connect is called No Need to Repay Me. Depending on the rarity, she increases the attack of the targeted ally for 35 or 40% and gives them a 100% chance to ignore a evade. The screen basically says her Magia, Light of Reckoning, deals damage to 5 random enemies on the field. But actually, she deals random damage 5 times, if you get what I mean. As a 4-star, she deals damage between 143 and 175%, and as a 5-star, between 151.5 and 183.5%, depending on Magia level, of course. She also has a chance to let the whole team ignore evades for one turn. This is a 70% chance at her 4-star rarity, and when she is a 5-star, the ignore evade buffs become guaranteed. Finally, she has a chance of applying a 90% damage cut to herself for one turn. The chance of the damage cut is between 55 and 65% as a 4-star, and between 80 and 90% as a 5-star, depending on Magia level. Her double, Kata Kombe, the double of disintegrations, deals 5 times randomly 401.4% damage. It gives the team a ignore a evade buff for one turn, and Kanagi will apply a damage cut on herself for 100% for one turn. So, after some of us thought that we would get Kanagi, and other people thought that we would get Ultimate Madoka, and many other people probably thought something else, but after we got Ultimate Madoka, Kanagi is finally here, so we can welcome her now. Her stats are pretty okay for a magical girl who focuses on dealing damage. She is a bit of a glass cannon, but her defense isn't too bad. Her Magia also helps her out a bit with her defense, but let's take a close look at her connect first. A 40% increased attack buff on her connect is good. It's also on par with the same buff from Reyna and Lin, for example. A buff like that is always useful, of course, but it isn't anything special since most magical girls increase the attack or damage that allies can deal with their connects. However, the 100% chance to ignore a evade is awesome. We have seen that Mel and Fate have the same buff, but it is not a 100% chance. Aimee has the same version as Kanagi, however, but she is actually a natural 3-star and she probably won't get uncapped anytime soon, so you might haven't used her yet. But anyway, this is a great addition to Kanagi's Connect. It can be very helpful to you in challenge quests where other magical girls can possibly evade attacks. With Kanagi's Connect, you will just make sure that you hit her, and with even more power thanks to the attack buff. Her magia is similar to Shizuku's and Mayu's, so if you already use them and their magias, then you might have a clearer idea how Kanagi's magia works. At first, I personally was very confused myself because I had 5 enemies on the field and she didn't hit all of them. And then when I used her magia on a single target boss, she suddenly hit that boss 5 times. But with that already comes one recommendation. You can use her magia best on single target bosses because she will consistently deal a huge chunk of damage. Random hits are just less effective when there are several enemies on the field, as I have hopefully demonstrated with my own experience. Let's just continue with her buffs and skills now. As a 5-star, she will give all allies a ignore evade buff, which is not guaranteed when she is a 4-star. Anyway, the buff can be great in some situations where enemies like to spam a evade. Furthermore, the damage cut is quite useful for Kanagi herself. However, especially as a 4-star, it doesn't have a high chance of applying, only 55-65%. Luckily, this upgrades at her 5-star rarity to a much higher chance, namely between 80-90%. The damage cut itself is great because it is 90%. She will hardly take any damage at her 5-star rarity, which is great for a glass cannon like herself. It definitely helps her survivability a lot. But do keep in mind, the damage cut might not stick. So, should you use Kanagi in PvP? Well, considering that many like to have a evade memoria on their magical girls, Kanagi's Connect would be a great option to counter that. The only thing you need to take care of is that she doesn't get defeated before you can use her Connect. Otherwise, she is still a great magical girl to use if we just look at her attack stat. Actually, Kanagi is pretty easy to put in teams, which is also thanks to her disc distribution and her specialization in ignoring evades. So she works great with many magical girls out there. She can be a supporter to other damage dealers thanks to this. Examples are Tsunano, Alina, Melissa and Lena. Of course, the options are not limited to them and you can put Kanagi in many teams. It is just great to use Kanagi's Connect on other great damage dealers so they can ignore a evade and still do a good chunk of damage. They, in return, also help out Kanagi. Most have some kind of increased damage or attack boost, except for Melissa, but she can help out Kanagi with removing debuffs and increasing her MP gain from Excel Discs for a faster magia attack. Furthermore, when you're up against enemies who like to spam evades on themselves, it can't hurt to put someone else in your team who can help the rest of your team to ignore those evades further. Great options are Fade, Mel, and or Imee. As I mentioned before, Imee also gives a ally a 100% chance to ignore a enemy's evade. Mel only gives 25 and Fade between 40 and 55%. So Mel isn't a great option, but if you don't have Fade or Imee or can borrow one, Mel is better than no extra connect, giving a chance to ignore a evade. Mel also has the chance to land many status ailments on the enemies with her Magia, the Poison, Bind, Darkness and Skill Seal status ailments. Although those aren't a 100% chance either, Fade is actually just a great magical girl to connect to with Kanagi because she will deal lots of damage. In return, Fade can do the same for Kanagi, of course. And Imee is simply great to use when you use several magical girls in your team with at least 2 or 3 blast discs, because she will increase damage on those with both her connect and Magia. Furthermore, with her Magia, she also gives the whole team a 3-turn 100% chance to ignore evades. So she is definitely great to bring alongside Kanagi to ignore evades. Great supporters for Kanagi would be Madoka or Umika. They both help out with survivability, and Madoka also with restore and MP. Madoka will restore MP with both her connect and Magia, and she helps with survivability in that her connect heals and her Magia gives a 3 turn damage cut. Umika is a bit different and her connect offers a damage cut together with some healing, and her Magia further heals all allies and removes any status ailments on them. Kanagi's personal memoria, a important uniform, will give her upon activation a ignore, evade and counter buff for 1 turn. It can be a useful memoria to use in challenge quests if the enemy uses any evades or counters. Other great memorias are I Made Friends and In the Light at Its Birth. Both these memorias give a increase in attack power but have different second abilities. I Made Friends gives you a chance to land a critical hit each time you attack, and In the Light at Its Birth gives a 75% chance to ignore a evade, so that is also great to use in PvP or in challenge quests. The Footstall Paradise Memoria is also decent. It will enhance 4 of Kanagi's 5 discs. It will increase blast damage and MP gain from Excel discs. If you want to increase Kanagi's defense, Blessed Wind Returns is a great pick. It will give you both a constant damage boost and damage cut, so it will definitely help out Kanagi with her survivability. For the future, you might want to look out for the power to protect who you love. This memoria will give Kanagi a constant damage cut and defense up buff. Once her HP reaches the critical state, it will further increase that defense buff. When max limit broken, you can get up to 85% protection with defense buffs. It will take a while before this memoria comes out. It will probably get released during the rerun, reaching a happier height event. In general, Kanagi is somewhat of a niche magical girl, though she is still quite useful outside her niche, and an easy magical girl to pair up with basically every other magical girl. So, do you have any gems left and will you pull for Kanagi? Feel free to let me know down in the comments below. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe if you did. You can also join our Discord server and follow me on Twitter. Links are in the description below, as well as my Magia Record player IDs if you wish to follow me. If you want to keep up to date with what I'm exactly doing, I highly suggest you follow me on Twitter or keep an eye out on my community posts, since I'm really trying to make more use out of it and keep you all updated. Or just join the Discord channel, that would be nice. Have a good morning, afternoon, night, or whatever your time zone is, and I hope to see you next time. Bye bye!